Hey, thanks for taking the time to watch this video, and be sure to stay tuned at the very end where I'm gonna talk about the most common mistake that amateur golfers make when it comes to chipping, and best of all, I'm gonna show you exactly how to fix it. All right, golfers, PJ teaching professional Todd Kobe here. We're gonna talk in this lesson about chipping, one of the most important parts of the game, you know, when eventually you're gonna miss a green and you gotta get that ball up and down to keep the round going, save a par, maybe even on a par five. You got an opportunity to make a nice, easy birdie. So when it comes to chipping, basically, I want to talk about three concepts here. Number one is club selection, number two is setup, and then, of course, number three is the actual motion. Now, when it comes to club selection, there's basically two philosophies. One is to use a variety of clubs, 8-iron, 9-iron, pitching wedge, lob wedge. The other philosophy is basically to use one or two clubs. And my suggestion is going to be, unless you're getting a lot of time to practice, is to stick with basically two clubs, probably like a pitching wedge and a lob wedge. So you're going to use your pitching wedge when you want to get the ball on the ground and you want to get it rolling a little bit. You're going to use your sand wedge or your lob wedge, whichever one is your most lofted club, when you need to hit the ball a little higher and a little softer. And I think that's going to be easier for you to learn, just basically two clubs and kind of stick with those two things. So that's my suggestion on club selection. Now the next is the actual setup. And the chipping motion is basically like a little mini golf swing. So I want your feet to be pretty close together. We definitely want some more pressure on the forward foot. So as a right-handed golfer, I'm gonna have probably 70% pressure on my lead foot. So my feet are pretty close together, definitely a little bit more pressure forward. Ball position, where should the ball be positioned in the feet? For most shots, I want the ball in the center of the stance. If you have a bad lie, maybe it's in deep grass, or maybe it's in a hole or a divot, something like that, then we should move the ball slightly back in the stance or towards the right foot if you're a right-handed golfer. The other key concept here in the setup is handle position, or where is the handle relative to the club head? Now, a lot of people, this is a common mistake, that they get the hands way too far in front of the golf ball, in front of the club head when they get ready to hit a chip shot. And that just de-lofts the golf club. So I want the hands in front of the ball, but only slightly in front of the ball. So those are kind of a couple of the key things when it comes to the setup. All right, so let's talk a little bit now about the actual motion, a chipping motion. What are we looking for? Well, first of all, on the backstroke, I want you to think of a phrase of catcher's mitt. So when you swing the club back, the most important thing is that the club head stays outside the hands. All right, because when the club head stays outside the hands, you have a good angle coming back into the golf ball, which is going to help you with clean contact. A common mistake I see a lot of golfers make is they drag the club head to the inside and then they'll tend to hit behind the golf ball. So the first phrase and the first thought is catcher's mitt, where the club head stays outside your hands. Now the other thing that I give a lot of my students, a good suggestion, is what a phrase we call high to low, because the actual motion on the backstroke should be slightly higher than the forward stroke. This will help you create a descending blow on the golf ball. So the phrase is high to low. A lot of golfers will do the opposite. They'll swing low on the back, high on the follow through, because they're trying to lift the golf ball, and this is just not good when it comes to chipping. The third and the final tip that I give you is on the finish. When you finish, the butt end of the club, for the most part, should be pointing at your belt buckle. And when it's pointing at your belt buckle, that tells me that you've maintained the correct loft on the golf club. All right, so let's do kind of a quick review on this. First of all, when it comes to club selection, pitching wedge and lob wedge is probably all you're going to need for 90% of the shots you see on the golf course. In the setup, feet are pretty close, pressure a little bit on the forward foot, ball's in the center so that the handle's pretty equal with it. In the actual motion, catcher's mitt going back, high to low, finish with the butt end of the club pointing at your belt buckle. If you do these things, you're going to hit some quality chip shots and you're going to save some nice pars, or maybe even get that ball up and down for an easy birdie. Thanks for taking the time to watch that video, and I hope that information helps you find your tour precision. Now, as I promised you, I want to give you the most common mistake that amateur golfers make when it comes to chipping, and here's what it is. When they're set up, a lot of them are told when they immediately take the club back to kind of hinge or cock the wrist. Now, what this does is it actually de-lofts the golf club, and most importantly, it takes all of the bounce out of the club, and that's just disastrous. What you want to actually do is, in the initial takeaway, you want to feel like you're pushing the handle away. Feel like the butt end of the club, the top part here, you push it away. And when you do this, it'll keep some loft on the golf club and most importantly, help you use the bounce. So hopefully that little tip there helps you. And be sure to subscribe if you haven't already, because we got great information coming out on a regular basis. And us here at US Golf TV are simply here to help you play better golf. kind of took a few, let's hold up. Hope you got that one. Those are some great things that we do. Do we dude.